Greetings everybody and welcome back to Stardew Valley and of course to Fuzzy Ferret Farm. It is a Monday and we've got a new episode of Living Off the Land to start the day with. It's salmon berry season all across the countryside. Bushes are teeming with juicy little berries and they're free for the taking. Harvesting them is a great way to earn some extra cash. Very well. Ooh, I see a glimmer within my scrying orb, a shard of knowledge from the future. The spirits are very happy today. They will do their best to shower everyone with good fortune. That is good. And it's going to be clear and sunny all day tomorrow. Okay, well, first and foremost... Ooh, we've got a letter. Hello, dear. I know you're just getting started as a gardener, so I wanted to give you a little tip. Most crops only grow in one season. When summer arrives, your spring crops will die out, so plan ahead. Thank you very much. Such a kind thing to do, just worrying after me. Even though I do already know this, I appreciate the thought to share your knowledge with me. Right, well, we definitely need to go and get some things. We'll also drop off this potato in there. The rest is coming with me. Well, the cauliflower's coming with me as well. That one doesn't need to go anywhere. Everyone is asking that I take... my items are gone. Alright. I guess I will take my diamond as well. I kind of want to keep that one. Now, it was pointed out that buying this was actually a poor decision at the time. Simply because I didn't need it yet. But I'm not going to need it for a while. And unfortunately, by buying it so early, I used up 1,000 gold, which I could have otherwise used. Now, I'm going to be getting all the salmon berries later on, because they're not time critical. So I can just go ahead and do my stuff, and we'll be fine. First thing, dropping off the cauliflower. This is one of the last things I need to drop off for the spring. Ooh, there's a daffodil over there. I'm probably not going to be able to pick it up for now, though. For the spring bundle. That is the spring crops. Right, let's go and say hello. Whoosh. No, that's the forage. We need to go up here, don't we? Yes. So, spring. Donk. Right, what are we going to get? We have got ourselves... speed grow. Fantastic. And off you go. Ooh, we've opened up something new. Is it going to be the bulletin board? No. It's going to be the boiler room, I think. Yes. Very well. Now, being super lazy, I'm not going to walk all the way over there. I'm just going to go straight through this to the boiler room. What do we need? Copper, iron, gold. Very easy to get. Aha! We can already deposit one of those, which I will do. And over there, just some essences. Okay, well, we'll go and... deposit the earth crystal straight away. That's rather good. There are only a few things left that are only available in spring for me to grab at this point. The cauliflower is now done. Let me drop that off. There we go. There is the gold grade parsnips, of which I need 3 more. I need an apricot, a cherry, a shad, a catfish, and a carp. I believe some of those can only, not only in spring, but they're definitely things I can get in spring. And in fact, part of what I'm going to be doing today is getting those things. Getting fish that only appear during this time. That is when it's raining. My hat is protecting me from getting wet, I am pleased. Hello? Ooh. So first read. There's a book missing here. There's also a book missing here. No? There we go. The Fisherman, Act 1. Tex. Gordy, how do you catch so many fish? For me, it takes forever. Gordy, you must make the choice to become a true fisherman, and over time, your fishing speed will increase. Tex. So, you're saying that improving my fishing skill will make me fish faster? Gordy. Correct. One day, you may even learn the secret to creating your very own bobbers, improving your mastery even more. Now be gone! Gordy's time is precious. You can't just take up all of Gordy's time asking silly questions. There is a diamond. There is a topaz. There is also an amethyst. And here is a starfish. I will place the starfish over there by the Nautilus shell. Doink. Let's go and read this other book. How deep do the mines go? This question has been pondered by many Stardew Valley explorers over the years. Truth is, no one really knows. Or at least, they aren't telling anyone. Unfortunately, many of those who venture deep into the mines never return. Only Marlon has ever returned after many successful voyages. We all know that he knows, but he's not letting on. However, there have been a few bold adventurers who have traveled deep into the mines and have resurfaced with interesting reports. Apparently, there are three distinct areas in the mines, each with unique monsters and treasures. Some adventurers speak of gigantic underground lakes and strange creatures, but none of these claims have been proven, though no one would doubt Marlon. Marlon is not the sort to lie. Right. Now, it should be time for me to go and sell some stuff. Ah, there we go. Now, I don't believe anyone's birthday is due for quite a while now. I think we're safe for a little bit. Ooh, also. Yoink. Thank you. Also. Yoink. There we are. I will be saving the salmon berries as per a suggestion because it's apparently Pam and Shane's... Oh, well, there we are. Pam and Shane's something that they quite like. So, yeah, we've got the end of the next episode will be Pam's birthday. So, I may splurge and get her a beer for that, though. It's a good day to shop. Indeed it is. It's a good day to sell you the things that I don't want, such as my potatoes and my agorina beans. And in exchange, I will purchase many parsnip seeds. Also, I guess I could get some cauliflowers. 12 days. It's the 15th. We would just about get a full cauliflower harvest. How long does kale take? 6 days to mature harvest with a scythe. Now, apparently kale doesn't do too badly, I was told. Sure, okay. We'll take kale because I'll be able to get quite a lot of that done. I'll take 19 of them. I will sell you one daffodil so that I can have 20 kale. Thank you. Also, let me have a chat with you. Most people stay indoors on days like this. It's not good for business. Well, such is life, I'm afraid, PA. Such is life. Right, I am going to go and I am going to fish. And I am going to fish from this bridge. Though, I guess it is a little bit silly because there's... Oh. Every possibility that all I'm going to find is Joja Cola. Because I'm right next to Joja. Also, someone has given me a tip that, frankly, I would never, ever have even thought of discovering. It's a bit of an Easter egg. It's one of those little plushes that you can find hidden away. So on the 28th day, let's hope I don't forget. And at 12 o'clock, I go and check a very specific bush. Oh, damn. A shad! Hooray! That's something I need. Okay, all I need now is a catfish and a carp. Max! Now, I'm deeply concerned about what I'm going to choose, bats or mushrooms. Now, bats is new and it would be interesting to check out. However, I strongly feel that mushroom is the better one to pick. Because bats are just going to give you fruit. And if you have any intention of planting fruit trees, which I do, then it's not the best thing to pick. Simply because you're going to be getting more fruit from the trees. Especially once you've got a greenhouse. Because they have re-added the ability to plant trees in the greenhouse now. They did take that out. But that's now been added back in. You can plant trees around the perimeter of the greenhouse. So, it does call into question how useful ever having the bat is going to be. Oh, no, come on. There we go. Especially considering the mushrooms are extremely difficult to get. You can only get them in certain seasons. 5 stones, really. That's just annoying. Go ahead, let me just eat the green algae. Get that out of my inventory. You can only get mushrooms in certain seasons in the secret forest. I'm not going to have the means to get to the secret forest. It's just not happening. Not this spring. It's extremely unlikely that I'll have the means to chop down that tree. Off to Joja, are you, Pam? Can't say I approve, really. No. Ah, damn it. I'm not moving. Can't you walk on the other side? Pam, seriously? Can't you see that I'm having an epic battle with fish right now? No, come on. Come on. I'm not a good enough fisher yet for you to be fighting me like this, whatever you are. I bet this is going to be a catfish, isn't it? Is it a catfish? Ha ha! All I now need is a carp. Managed to catch you on like fishing level 2, catfish. Ah, I am pleased. Mind you, I've got an upgraded rod, so it, you know. No bait, though. So, you know, it's not like I'm really stacking the odds in my favor here. I will have one more fish. This is unlikely to be a carp, I would say. It's too... No, it was a shed. Right, well, I'm going to go and drop these off, and then we can go do something else. Now that I've got the catfish and the shad, which are the only two that... Yeah, I don't think the carp needs to be gotten in the... Can I get through there? Yes, I can. Needs to be gotten in rain, so we're good on that one, actually. Hello. Riverfish, catfish, shad... All that remains now is a tiger trout. Tiger trout, tiger trout, tiger trout. I think tiger trout are autumn fish. Could be wrong. I'm fairly certain they are. Okay, well, we'll have to wait on that one then. Go and get some more salmon berries. Fuel for Shane and Pam's affection. Let's go see if I can find Pam. I don't want to go into Jojo Mart. I would be happy if I go through this entire playthrough without ever having to step inside Jojo Mart. That would actually make me very, very pleased. I'd feel that I have accomplished something worth accomplishing. Anyone around? Oh, of course they're not going to be around. It's raining. Why would they be around? Well, because I would be around. But I'm weird and I accept this. All these people hiding from the rain. Do they not understand that water is the basis of our lives? That and carbon. It's hard to hide from carbon, though. Very, very difficult, in fact. I would not recommend making that your life goal. You will fail. Collect some more salmon berries as we walk around. I will catch Shane and Pam probably at the saloon later on, so I don't need to worry too much about catching them out and about, but there we go. Now, I have no idea how much they like salmon berries. I'm hoping they like them a lot. But, you know, there's no particular guarantee about that. Right, I need the fertilizer as well, please. Now, we've got enough time to get a good number of these done. Doop, 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 doop. It's nice to have the rain today, honestly. It would have been especially nice to have had the rain tomorrow as well. Now, speed grow. If I'd realized that I was going to get a load of speed grow, I would 100% have held off on planting those bloody strawberries. And we've got a remaining 6. Well, there's no easy pattern that's going to hold all of this, but sure. And an extra one to go right about there. There we go. Right, we can drop these off now. They can all go in there. I'll be keeping the speed row, obviously. Right, let me have a quick look. What can I craft? I can craft a crab pot. I need 3 iron bars, though. Not going to be easy. Not going to be easy at all. 40 wood, 2 copper bars. Have I got 2 copper bars? I do. Yes, let us get a... Right, I need maple syrup. All right. So... Tapper. Let's drop these off. Honestly, and this is going to be incredibly ignorant of me. Oh, wait, no. Actually, before I was going to do that, damn, we need to cut down a certain type of tree. Let me go and grab one. Yoink. Ah, damn it. Sod it. Okay, fine. I'll go through you. All of the trees that I want are down this side. Okay, this is where my energy goes. There we are. Also may as well cut you down as well since I'm here. So frustrated that I lost that. Those saplings. Man, really? Ooh, we've got some seeds. Fair enough. And we've got some more trees down here we can go for. Honestly, I need to get rid of a couple of these. I'm not sure if having the grass around is actually good for this, the trees propagating, though. Nope. Like. Go for you. Still have no acorns, unfortunately. I'm very sad. There we go. The game heard me, and I was like, oh, I don't want you to be sad, Aavak. This is meant to be a lovely game. Relaxing and pure in all ways. Thank you, game. I appreciate it. And actually, that's enough saplings, I would say. But since I'm down this way anyway, let's go ahead and finish clearing things up. Okay, and you as well. Have I got enough energy for this? Debatable. Debatable on that one. Damn it. Right, let's go up. Drop off these acorns. Just need to get them on the grow. There we go. We can drop off a load of other stuff. Boop. Boop, boop. All of that. Got a nice bit of wood there now, which is grand. I guess I'll drop those off for now. Yeah, you know what? Let's do a little bit more wood choppering. I think it's worth our time. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to get through this before passing out, though. Yes! Ha ha! Ha ha! Nice try, but no. Oh dear. No, no, leave me alone. Bad bats. No, yep, that's right. Got ya. Oh, narrowly dodged. Narrowly. Leave me alone, bats. Right, let's drop these off. And, yeah, let's go ahead and make ourselves a field snack for tomorrow. And drop off my axe as well. Right, I'm fairly happy with what we managed to do today, to be perfectly honest with you. Low energy now, but still, that was a solid day's work. Oh, well, 8:50. You know what? No. It's a little bit early. I'm not going to turn in just yet. No, leave me alone, bat. Leave me alone. Oh, my goodness, I'm just as fast as you are. Ah, that is ridiculous, by the way, that I'm as fast as a bat. Bats are really, really quick. Not so quick when they're crawling on your hand. Then they're kind of slow and derpy and cute. But really fast when they're flying. I have curious taste in animals. I must confess. So many people are like, why have you got ferret pets? Are you strange? No, you just don't understand them. And by the same token, why do you like holding bats? They're just strange. They're like sky rats. Like, no, you just don't understand them. You go. You did good with this one, kid. Thanks. Fantastic. Hey, kid. I'd buy you a drink if I could afford it. You can't. It's okay. Hi there, Aavak. I'm glad to see you. You're always welcome here. Never rains a calico desert. That's where my friend Sandy lives. I wish I could have visited it today. Have a daffodil. Thank you. I'm feeling a positive energy from this gift. I'm glad. Maybe I should cook something new and exciting today. Something spicy. Spicy food. I need a little warming up to be ready for another cold night on the ocean. Unfortunately, I've missed Harvey. Yep, I'm a blacksmith. My father was also a blacksmith. My grandfather was also a blacksmith as well. I bet you can't guess what my great-great-grandfather was. Sarcastic jerk. A blacksmith. How'd you know? This weather makes me thirsty. Well, have this succulent berry. This is great. Thanks. Ha-ha! There we are. I'm tricking him into not drinking. I will save you. One salmon berry at a time, Shane. Right, well, that's it for a fairly productive day. I get walloped going through here. I'm going to be a little bit sad. I can do it. I can do it. I wish I'd decided to do it before I'd already walked most of the way home, but I can do this. Let's go. Time is of the essence. We must make it through the beach. We must scour the beach for good things. I'm not going to fish, unfortunately. I could eat my salmon snack and then fish. No, no. I must hold back. Let us not be greedy. There is no need to do that. Let's just go and pick up beautiful things on the beach. In the moonlight. This is lovely. Okay. We have a clam. Anything else around here? We have a urchin or an urchin. A sea urchin, an urchin. It's always good to be specific because, you know, someone might think you're talking about actual urchins, and that's going to confuse everything. There we go. Right, we've got to make a pretty swift move back. Hi, Willy. Bye, Willy. Hi there, son. Looks like decent weather for fishing, eh? Yeah, actually it does. Also for taking long walks on the beach. The moon's silverish glow cast across the sandy dunes. Good night, Leah. I hope you enjoy the walk back home in the rain. No, I'm not being sarcastic. Stop giving me that look. 12:30. We can do this. You just need to not be accosted by bats. Also, do I need to drop off a clam? Crab pot bundle. Yes, I do. So one clam must be saved. Excuse me. I am very pleased with what we've managed to do today. Ouch! That hurt. That really hurt. Why did you do it? Scallywag, leave me alone, all of you. No, don't want to play. Hey, it was a rough day today, Leafy, and I'm glad I got to speak to you before I went to sleep, though. Yes, go to sleep. I'm going to have low energy, though. Tomorrow's energy is going to be rubbish. I'm going to have to eat that field snack just to keep myself going. Oh, well. We got 50 for the clam, 200 for the silver sea urchin, though. We also got 120 for the two shads. Not too bad, not too shabby at all. Cock-a-doodle-doo indeed. Right, let's start the day correctly by checking the fortune teller. So it's a very happy today. I'm very glad about that. What about the weather report? It's going to be clear and sunny all day, which means I've got a lot of work. So much work to do. So much. Pop that in there. Right. Dear neighbor, I hope you're feeling settled in your new home. I'm writing to let you know that Pierre's store is now selling fertilizers. Why don't you swing by and see if you can afford a few dozen boxes or so? Pierre, I just bought out so many plants. Why, you greedy? I understand. You're a businessman. However, I am a farmer, and that means I need to take care of my plants. So I will bring you all back when I have finished doing so. We're on our third refill. Though, to be fair, this watering can was about half empty when I started using it. So I'm not going to hold that against it. I really wish I'd realized I would be able to get the speed grow for this, though. Oh, that's so annoying. Have you scared of any crows yet? No, sorry. I'm scared of one crow. Well done. I'm very proud of you. Very proud. You're doing good work here. Also, I want my chests to grow into big chests. That's why I'm watering them. Yep, absolutely how it works. Right, well, considering the day, where should we go? I've got virtually no energy, so the mines are almost entirely out of the question. Let's see. We could... Well, as much as the mines are out of the question, I kind of need to go to the mines. It's pretty much one of the only other places I can go. However, I think our new... The next layer of the... No, it's not that layer of the mines, unfortunately. I was going to say the next layer of the mines is likely going to involve the fishing spot, so I could do a little bit of fishing, you know, charge my energy. We'll swing around the town, see what's about, what we can get, and maybe we'll... something will leap out at us. We can, you know, spend some time. Actually, we'll grab some of our daffodils, take them with us as well. Also, the clam. We need to take the clam to the community center. Oh, there's loads of things I can do today. Never mind. There I was, thinking that there wasn't much. I'm gonna be honest. You're gonna be eaten. And you're gonna be left there. And you're definitely going to be eaten, as are you. Anything else? I'll bring a daffodil with me. Right, first and foremost, time for norms. I really wish I could cook. So bad. So bad. Never have I felt so dumb for not being able to, I don't know, just even roast the fish over the fire or something. Why is my farmer so bad at just basically living? I mean, I don't know. I genuinely don't know. If someone was born in the city, their whole lives born in a city, I'd never really been to the country, never been out camping, never played in the backyard that happened to be a mountain and a forest, would they necessarily know this sort of stuff? I can't guarantee that they would, and I feel a little bad for, you know, berating people. It's just not something they understand. I mean, I had one friend who lived in the city, and she said that she was like 14, 15 at the time, this was several years ago, and she said she'd never seen a tree that was not part of a manicured park, like never seen a wild tree. I know it sounds silly to say a wild tree, but I'd never seen a tree that had grown there because it had simply grown there. And it was, not even talking forest, we're just talking trees now. And it's like, I honestly thought she was pulling my leg for a very long time, but she was quite genuine about it. It's like, wow, that honestly breaks my mind. It doesn't blow it, it just snaps it. My brain makes a decided noise and just snaps. Hey, if you need any materials or blueprints, my shop is the place you're looking for. Thank you. I do quite often, actually. Also, here. Thank you, this might come in handy. Yes, if you wish to impress any of your friends. If you want to increase your relationship with any of the townsfolk, they are very, very useful. There we go. So, there's only a couple of things that we need at this point. I'm fairly certain we can find cockles just out and about. I might need a crab pot for that one, though. Either way, we're very close to finishing that particular bundle. Ooh, what do we got here? Sebastian is in need of a herring. Okay. I'll do my best, Sebastian. Yeah, we're good. Hello, Marnie. My nephew Shane has been staying at my place for the last few months. I know, I've met him a few times. Ooh, hello, Maro. Have you met my mother? She's the town's carpenter. Yes, I've been to your house several times. Have you not noticed? Hello, Doctor. Feel free to stop by my office if you're ever feeling ill. Well, I'm not feeling ill. I just wanted to stop by and say hello, really. Hi, Leah. Hello, neighbor. Oh, man, she doesn't even remember my name. My heart broke a little bit then. That sucks. Oh, well. I'm off to the mines, I guess. I would give Linus a daffodil, but I'm not sure he'd appreciate it as much as he'd appreciate the salmon berry. And I like him better than I like either Pam or Shane, so the salmon berry is his if he wants it. There we go. I am not going to chop this tree down this time. I know how significant that tree is now. I feel bad about chopping it down the first time. Hello. This is a great gift. Thank you. You're welcome, Linus. How are you doing, by the way? Have you come to ridicule? What? Sometimes this game. Sometimes. You know what? I'm going to fish to make myself feel better for Linus not trusting me. And Leah forgetting my name. These are dire times, ladies and gentlemen. Dire times. We've got friends and more than friends from a different time who just don't remember who I am, and then we've also got people who've never seen real wild trees and a chub. Apparently I do actually need one of those. In the end. Apparently that is actually needed for some particular fishing thing. But thing is, I don't think it's actually very difficult for me to get, so I'll keep it just in case. There we go. Ah, damn it. Well played, fish. Cunning, one would say. Have I got a carp? Yes, I knew it was going to be a carp because of how lethargic it was. I'll try once more, because if I can get a second carb, because they're fairly good energy. Oh, actually, no, they're not. They're only 13. Wow. All right. I take it back. I was deeply mistaken. Ah, you know what I should have done? I should have brought enough materials to make a chest. Drat. Drat, drat, drat. Okay, well, I guess we're going to go in there. Oh, no, I've already done it. I am clever. I am happy. These can go in there. There we go. I will get you back when I come back. Right, off we go into the mines. We're not particularly here to progress, really. I mean, it's always nice if I can make it down an extra 5 every time I come down here, but it's not strictly my focus right now. Get you. What I would like to be doing is actually hoeing all of this, but I would want a much better hoe for that, to be perfectly honest with you. Oh, I need you for the community bundle. Grab you. Nope. Come on. Just be dead. Death. Yes. More copper. I need to get enough to upgrade my axe. I really want to get my axe up as fast as I can. Also, something for Gunther. Fantastic. Right, well, you can go in the bin then. Nope. Stun locked. Best kind of locked. There we are. Okay, well, looks like I am going to be hunting around. Oh, actually, you know what I can do? I can immediately turn that into bait to clear up the inventory room. Ah, there we are. How handy. Ooh. Yes. I will accept this torch. I may need it later on. Thank you. Thank you as well. Also you. Okay. I like this music, actually. Well, I'm not going to go down yet because I know what's at the end of this. Cool. Also another stairs if I wanted to use it. And you. Oh dear. Well, you know what? You're not dangerous enough for me to worry about. Ouch, I say, and then get hurt. Come hither. There we are. Bug meat is important. Damn. I guess the stones can go down. Yeah, I guess the stones can go down. There we go. Right. Now I can see! Not that I need to right now. I was about to say, is there nothing under the ground? Why am I attacking you from the wrong direction? That's seriously dumb. You had an amethyst in you? How bizarre. Get you. Nope. 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 I guess yes, maybe. Nope. Nope. Haha! Well, I suppose I don't really need that. Again, lots of bug meat here. Lots of bait for future. Right, time to nom. Thank you. I think we'll actually continue to get everything that's on this area. It's too useful not to. Fair old bit of copper here. No, thanks. There we go. Nope. Ah, damn it. Twice, really? Yoink. Scare both of you. Shouldn't need to block as long as I keep up the attack, basically. No more of those digging bugs. That's a little bit of a shame. Oh, no, there we go. There we are. Oh, damn it. They actually hit like a truck. Okay, well, that's good enough. Oh, hello. Please be dead. And one or two more hits. No? A couple more than I was expecting. Right, we've got... It's 7:30. We've still got enough energy to keep going, I think. We're at level 13. If we now make it a priority to get it to level 15, then we can at least say we've gone down 5 levels, which is very important. Oh, damn it, I was a little bit slow on the block there. Then we can come down and start from that area next time. We'll only be 5 levels away from the fishing area in the mines at that point, which will be particularly useful for me. We'll get rid of the fiber. Go. Anything else here? Doesn't look like it. Okay, well, I'll have to start digging then in search of the stairs down. Have I got anything I can eat? This is annoying. Nope. Ow. Stop it. Damn it. Come hither, you scallywag. Oh, dear. Come back here. Ah. That was worrisome, to be honest. Well, I've got my way down. Well, you know what? I'll just take it. Right, there we are. We're going to go back up now. We've gone to level 15, and that's, frankly, great. I want to take that with me. That can be dropped off. These are obviously coming with. Well, I want to take the carp. I want to take the chub. I kind of want to take the salmon berries with me. Quartz needs to go to Gunther, though. I can drop that off. And I can drop that off for now. There we go. I'll come back and gather them up later. But I think we did a fairly good job there, actually. In fact, I should be able to drop off the carp in the community center on my way back. So we'll go back the regular way. Not a bad 2 days. I feel that we've done a fairly good bit of work. We've finally planted all the rest of my plants. I'm a little bit saddened by having missed a few days with that one, but oh well. Alright, let's drop this off, shall we? Is that River? No, it's not River Fish. Lakefish, I think. There we go. Lakefish it is. Okay, significant progress. Ooh, wait. I think the quartz needs to go over here as well. Significant progress made on our bundles. Our spring bundles specifically have been greatly enhanced. There's very few things that are now limited that you can only get in spring that we do not have. Unfortunately, I'm just going to have to rely on the merchant for the fruits. I'm fairly certain I'm not going to be going with the bats. It doesn't make as much sense. The fruits will be coming through. I can make them myself. I cannot make mushrooms myself. So I would be entirely dependent on the seasons and luck to get any kind of specific mushroom. Whereas, I mean, it's still going to be a little bit of luck with the mushroom cave. It's going to be a bit better. Yeah, we're not going to be dropping anything off today. I'll drop off the chub. We will start smelting. I will also drop off one. No, actually, I'll take that. There we go. That can go in there. So can you. So can you. We're not going to go to the mines again tomorrow, I don't think. Let's see. Copper doesn't usually take that long to smelt. But given that I'm not going to the mines tomorrow, actually, I guess it doesn't really matter. I can just drop off the copper and the coal. Can you organize that for me? Thank you. Same in here. Same over here. Same over here. There we are. We haven't really got that many things that we'd need to organize. Oh, never mind. There we go. It actually really doesn't take that long. I'll grab one, and I'll grab 5, and then I'll go to sleep, leave that smelt overnight. There we go. Right. And it's off to bed. A reasonable time to go to bed, too, I feel. I did pet Leafin while I was watering the plants, and also watered him by accident. This is the way it's going to be. This is how you make dogs grow, I'm fairly certain. Right. Go to sleep for the night. Yes. Ah. We didn't learn anything, unfortunately. It's not always going to be the case that we do. But that's going to be it for this episode. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And remember to like if you liked and sub if you haven't. But until next time, do take care, everyone.